So that's the situation here at Witteburg Hoërskool in Bethlehem. They're singing their songs. Their spirit certainly hasn't abated. But it's been a really tough first half. Kicks were traded initially. The first one through an accidental obstruction. And Etienne Becker put Bethlehem Voortrekker on the board in the 25th minute of the first half. 3-0, the visitors leading. Huge crowd in here at Witteburg. Stop the town, this local derby, this FNB and classic FNB classic clash. And then the equalizing moment, this penalty. Going over the ball, illegally turning it over, didn't weren't allowed to come back for the second grab. Tion Schoenrod, this polished-looking fly half, levels the scores, and then on the break of halftime, there was an error as there was an attempted counter from Witteburg. Yeah, above the skipper, flings the pass infield to Minar, picked up by Malensi, as any good flanker should be. The handoff, Labuschagne's inside him, he's got any number he wants because Jordan is the only one coming across from cover. Labuschagne gets through at the corner and puts it in the lead with a handy cushion, 10-3 at the break.
Well, it was good play from Saki Molense, pouncing on that ball, recovering it, streaking up the far touchline, timing his pass to perfection. Support was there in the form of Labuschagne, and the rest is history.
It is a festival atmosphere here for this FNB Classic Clash. Both schools occupy the end of the ground and the stands are absolutely full. There are the stats of the match. You can see far too many handling. Penalties conceded aplenty. And the line-out has been a very awkward source. Far too many one against the throw.
Well, it has been an awkward source. Both sets of locks are contesting perfectly. Berger Marais on his opposition ball. Not going through many phases. Only once past five phases or more, and the ruck and maul situation. Witteburg leading that at the ruck time. They've had a bit more possession at certain periods of the game.
So 35 minutes to play for the bragging rights for yet another year, and those bragging rights have belonged unequivocally with Bethlehem Voortrekker over the last, what is it, 8 years since Witteburg prevailed. They still have a chance. They trail by just 7. But you can sense just the pace of the play from the both sides. Feel the pressure of the derby.
Well, Witteburg's saying is to make memories, moments and magic. And they definitely want to make some magic in this second half.
With the breeze at their back, Bub gets things underway. They come forward with purpose. Tap down on the Witteburg side. But Voortrekker, the first to claim. But it was off a black fingertip. So Witteburg, the opportunity of field position with the early scrum.
There was some nice hang time from that dropout. And it's not easy to take it. It's an art. Your lock forward has to have full concentration, full sight of the ball, and good support from behind.
Now, we've made mention that the Witteburg pack is significantly heavier, but their scrumming hasn't been as proficient. In fact, Voortrekker put them under pressure the bulk of the time. There again, there's this shove from Voortrekker, giving this bad ball and almost waiting for it to pop out, and it's been turned over, has it? Shrill blast, and the penalty comes the way of the superior scrum.
That was a perfectly timed scrum from Bethlehem Voortrekker. Total cohesion, good timing, and as that ball came in, the pressure came through. Take a look at that, an immense pressure. The big tight head, Anders Buerta, scrumming it in and around. Very good scrum from Voortrekker.
Well, Peter Kleinon certainly getting the better of Anders Buerta. The line out now for Bethlehem Voortrekker is claimed by Michael Janssen van Rensburg. He has been a good source of ball at the back of the lineup, and now they will try and control it. Becker away to Kleinhans, lining deep. Here's the try scorer, Labuschagne. He gets enveloped by Tion Schoenrod and Van Ballon, but the presentation is good for Voortrekker. Peter Kleinhans is the carrier. Another penalty. My word, they are coming thick and fast.
From the side, number 13.
definite lateral entry from Bethlehem Voortrekker at the ruck situation. So Witteburg with a chance to just calm down the nerves, get down into the Voortrekker half. Tian Schoenrock needs to make sure of this touch.
And he's not going to make sure. Oh, he is. It's a great kick. Initially, I thought he'd hit it a bit too far infield. He took his time to decide which side of the field to kick to. But now that is as good a strike as he's had all day. And he set up a wonderful field position. Can they secure the line out there? A source that has been so unpredictable inside, for the home side.
What has been inside. A problem area from them. Just need to slow it down. Maybe throw a front ball, a banker ball.
Jordan goes to the front. Peter Jordan claims. Now will they try and maul it up against this resolute Voortrekker pack? No, they don't. But away to Schoenrock. Crossfield to Van Biljon. Going very lateral. Pops it up. Around comes Schoenrock looking for support. Not close enough at hand. Bienica trying to make a bridge. But they're more in number there are. Bethlehem Voortrekker, they get more to the breakdown than do the visitors, and that's why the protection of the ball isn't that good for Witteburg.
Well, definitely, Witteburg need to get numbers at that, immediate numbers at the breakdown situation. Voortrekker at the moment being ruthless, getting bodies, getting numbers, and body positions are good.
Jordan, and it's claimed against the throw again, my word. Berger Maria and Eben Klaassen have been good for Bethlehem Voortrekker. They lead by 10 points to 3. 4 minutes gone in the second half. Kleinhans. Oh, the step midfield from the big fellas of Bethlehem Voortrekker, who are playing with a little bit more belief. Klaassen carries it up to the 10. Becker wants it and goes for the box. Bienica has read it comfortably. He will counter and he will chip. He doesn't chip very well. He's used that little try to just poke it over the top of the on-rushing defense any number of times. Sometimes it's worked. Most times it's been unsuccessful.
Just chipping it totally incorrectly. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. But what I've noticed, both sides migrate towards the ruck. There's often space available on the blind side, Brett.
The carry-out now is Crocky Maiden. Trying to get numbers midfield. Handespoor to the dummy run. Schoenrock, there's the kick again, and it goes off a Voortrekker defender. And it should be Witteburg ball on the halfway line.
Both sides trying to keep ball in hand in their attacking options, varying it, sometimes putting it on the grubber, sometimes trying to use a little chip kick. And it's due to the fact that the rush defense of both sides has been prominent all afternoon.
Witteburg nicely at the front. Down quickly to Liamza James. And they will try and muscle their way. Here comes James as he breaks away with it and drives up towards the 10 meters line. Bub wants, Bub gets. Schoenrock. Longer pass. Rude. Out to Bienica. He's created the extra man. He goes inside. Can he keep going? He needs support. There's not another white jersey to be seen. That was an excellent space creation by Witteburg. Here's Bub again. Up to Jordan. That's the try line atop your screen. The bodies there are slow in number for the men in white. Bub again. Schoenrock. Across field now for Rue. Liamza James. Out to Vian Minar. He stops, steps in field and loses it forward. So there's turnover ball. Marco Labaskachny protects for Bethlehem Voortrekker. My word, they've had their chances at Witteburg, but failed to take them. Back to Kleinhans. Left boot. Won't find touch. Finds Bub, who loses it. Inside him is Jordan. Does he want him? He goes to the sky. Jordan running onto it. Contests with Eben Klaassen. But it's Voortrekker who come away now. Coming the short side. Jordan makes a powerful tackle on Wanrick Eger. Becker in there looking for it. Away to Kleinhans. Labaskachny. Space has been at a premium. It's closed down so quickly. Turned over by Witteburg, but it's gone loose. And the first to claim is Berger Maria. Gets inside Witteburg territory. Becker, away to Kleinhans. He took his time. Oh, and he's thumped to the ground, but he wasn't speared. Oh, the referee maybe thinks otherwise. Lovely pass and field. Donovan Bowe carries it on. Advantage being played to the increasing momentum of Bethlehem Voortrekker. They've got numbers out on the right if they can get it there. Boa, Lavaskachny, out to Victor. Victor speeding down the right flank as quickly swamped. Still advantage. Lost forward now by Voortrekker, so they will have the penalty. Bodies prone everywhere as the pace and the hardness of the game starts to knock the stuffing out of these two sets of schools.
Mark, yeah?
Oh, fantastic build-up from the Bethlehem Voortrekker side. And what was nice about that sortie of play, Brett, is the offload and the tackle and the ball carrying on with momentum. Wasn't such a tight tackle. Pretty harsh done by it. Was not a spear tackle, but it's almost as if little Bertus Kleinhans almost jumped into that tackle, so made it look a bit more severe than what it did.
Certainly stayed down for a while as the wind was knocked out of him. But he has a chance to stretch the lead. They've had their chances at Witteburg, and every time they've got close, they've turned it over, and they've been punished. Bethlehem Voortrekker, through the boot of their scrum half, Etienne Becker, with a chance to put the lead to double figures. Kicking directly into the stiffish breeze. The strike is sound, but he exclaimed immediately, ah, and from that you could gather he'd pushed it away to the right. So Witteburg can breathe again.
Another dangerous tackle high from Daryl Wilson, going around the neck. Let's remember you have to tackle around the legs, around the waist.
Bob goes deep. Lavaskachny runs straight into Wilson, bounces off him and keeps going. Nuggety center, solitary try scorer.
Fight more.
Action taking place on the center spot.
Leave it now, leave it
white. Contested illegally sometimes. Away comes Tion Fonsale. Support arrives to present for Becker. Away to the skipper, Bauer. Strong runner. Becker again. Numbers away to the right if they can get it through the hands. The step in field is from Eben Klaassen. And he's away in the lock forward. Finds good support from Lavaskachny inside. There was an early tackle there. There was an early tackle. And there's a penalty. And that might mean greater sanctions for Witteburg.
Right. Not allowed, eh?
He's going to the sock, is referee in BC. Is he going for a card down there? Yep, he is. There it is. 10 minutes in the bin. Witteburg down to 14 men.
Okay.
Problems now for the home side.
Well, it's almost as if Voortrekker have upped the gear. Fantastic interplay between Eben Klaassen and his fellow lock partner, who was tackled definitely early.
Nick O'Neill, the man who's been sent to the bin for 10 crucial minutes, and from straight in front of the post, this time you would expect Becker to give Bethlehem Voortrekker a deserved and a handy lead. Straight in front, crowd hushed, soon to erupt. Those behind the post certainly do. Those from Bethlehem Voortrekker are growing in confidence now, because they look like a side that has got victory in their sights. Still time to go, but 13-3 in a tight game is a good advantage.
Well, it's a total different side in the second half. It almost seems as if their nerves have settled down. They're playing, giving continuity to the game. They're offloading in the tackle. The ball is moving. Their retention skills are good. They're looking good in the second half, Brett.
They have done. As they have in the first, they were good on defense. Their ability to turn over ball and probably principally from the line-out. That set piece has been poor for Witteburg. The forwards of Bethlehem Voortrekker are superior. They contest there, that nicely hanging kick from Donovan Bubb. Where will it be revealed? It's coming back for the visitors once again. Becker, Kleinhans, Lubberskoffny steps, and the tackles are starting to be brushed off now. Here's Lubberskoffny away, straight downfield, still going. Lubberskoffny, support inside, caught from behind. Oh, the pass was forward. The pass was forward. That's the side of a side whose spirits are flagging. The tackles are slipping off a little now, and Lubberskoffny with that lovely run.
22. Yep, 17.
Well, slipping off tackles are the Witteburg side, but Lubberskoffny stepping inside, stepping out. Fortunately, that last pass just going slightly
anybody
forward.
Qualified, Captain? Anybody qualified,
tackles made at the moment. Witteburg have had to make 47. Okay. Tackles missed are 17, and that is concerning for this home side.
Substitution looks like it's going to be made. Well, it has to be made, doesn't it? Because there's a man in the sin bin. So, coming onto the park is Tumi Ramaseli.
5-5 off. Right, 7-7 in the scrum, guys. Please adapt.
And going off.
Yes, 7-7.
Being sacrificed is Kroki Maiden. So, down a man. And in trouble, trailing on the scoreboard. Witteburg.
Well, down a man and up against Voortrekker at scrum time. And Voortrekker have looked impressive.
They certainly have. They won't mind if the clock just keeps ticking away. There's still plenty of time to go, but when you're leading, and a handy lead nonetheless, time is your friend.
Crouch, bind, sit.
A slewing scrum, but to feed.
Was out.
Immediately under pressure, but it was a good quick heel. So Skunrock can thump it downfield onto Victor, who does well and takes. Feeds inside to Janssen van Rensburg.
Right, roll four.
Aims for the halfway line. And recycling is good. Kleinhans. And there's space out here on the left. This is Molensi. Support from Eger, picked up by Lombard. They are growing in confidence of the visitors, and Witteburg are in danger of being put away here. Tian van Sale runs into a double tackle from Bienica. And Jordan, who's not getting up easy. The penalty comes the way of Bethlehem Voortrekker. And there may be another kick at goal here for Bethlehem Voortrekker.
Who's the captain? Number nine. Number nine.
Right. Well, it's good interplay between the outside backs.
Any more infringements in this zone?
Carrying the ball well is the Voortrekker side. Retention is good. Pick and go.
Right. Last time speaking to you.
JJ Lombard. An infringement coming down at ruck time. Not rolling away. It's the big tight head prop, Hundus Boerta.
22 white. 14 white, come off. 14 white.
So a substitution being made while this
stop the time.
Injury has occurred. Looks like for Witteburg, Shepi Morfokeng is coming on for Vion Minar. You'll notice that the clock doesn't stop. It's always running time in these FNB Classic clashes. So as precious minutes tick away for Witteburg, but the attention has to be given. It looks like Jordan is down.
It's a good carry again by Tian van Sale. Not releasing the ball on the ground. You see clearly Anders Boerta is holding on to that ball. You have to be on your feet. Giving the penalty away. It's going to be interesting. I think looks like they're going to take a kick at for touch, Brett.
Yeah, try and really put the nail into the coffin here instead of just eking it away. Oh, 3 points. Their lineup's been good. We saw their drive from the lineup well executed in the first half, and this could be a chance to put the game away.
Let's remember Witteburg with a yellow card at the moment, so they only gain 7 up front.
Tian van Sail. Berger Marais has been a tower of strength in the line-out. Where will they go? Indeed they do. Here's the maul. Here's the control. The crowd behind the try line are all Bethlehem Voortrekker folk. They want to get them over. They are over. They are down. There is the try. Surely that is it now. Is there a way back for Witteburg? Saki Malense, it looks like, who's got in for the try for Bethlehem Voortrekker. And he's deserved that. He really has had a good game. Instrumental in setting up the first try. The scorer of the second.
Well, it's a good take in the middle of the line-out. The platform is set. Even though Witteburg are trying to wheel it towards the right, they keep control, they keep leg drive. Take a look at the little scrum half, Etienne Beckers. He's got his hand in the air already before they even over the try line. He knows that the try is good.
What impact did that try on the stroke of halftime, that given away try that made Bethlehem Voortrekker lead 10 points to 3? Did that just sap the morale to a degree of the home side? It should have been 3 all at the break. It wasn't to be. And everything's gone the way of the visitors here in the second half. Not just by fortune, but by design. Here is Becker, and he's just going to push it away. 18 points to 3, though. That is a mountain to climb for the home side.
It's a fantastic take. Platform is set. Body positions are good. The bind is good. They're nice and tight. They don't get wheeled. It doesn't get disrupted. The control is good. And Molense goes over for a cracker.
They need something to go their way, Witteburg, to get back in there. The restart from Bub is a good one, but there's no chasers. Jordan is the only one there, and he makes his presence felt. Still, though, Bethlehem have it. Rabiskopny will run. He will spin out to Victor. Steps inside Jason Roux. Steps inside Rudolf van Billion. Doesn't get away from Stefan Jordan, but his offload is beautifully executed and taken in by Donovan Boer. Penalty coming the way of Witteburg, and they need that.
Let you let go of the ball once you place it, please. Leave it.
What do they do now? What do they do? It's catch-up time for the game. Do they go for 3, try and just edge away at this lead, or do they set up a line-up, and it's a phase of play that hasn't been very good for Witteburg. That's where they're going. Them from here, they have to score if they're going to have a chance to stay in this game.
Well, this is vital for them in this FNB Classic clash. They need to score points. They need to come away with points, at least a try from this line-out. They've been good at their front ball. They're bankable the whole game. Their number 8 has done well there, Peter Jordan.
They go to Henny Kutsia. Round they come. Here's the drive. It's a counter. Is it a score? It's held up, says referee in BC. They can't believe it in the crowd. Liamza James thought he was in for the try, but held up is the call, an important call from referee MCB.
Right. Thank you.
It was a good take, but
right.
Ball to the back, but breaking away. Well defended from Voortrekker, sacking it immediately. As you can see, the ball is in the air, so it will be a scrum. Let's remember it's 7 against 8 due to the fact of a yellow card going the Witteburg way from their big tight-head prop, Hundus Buerta. The yellow card is back, so we even Stevens up front, 8 against 8. Lovely little blindside area to attack by. If Buerta can get a good tight-head lean, it means the opposition defense, the flanker, is out of play. So there could be a nice occasion here on this blind side.
It's a must score time now for Witteburg. Trailing by 15.
6.
13 minutes and change remaining. There's the feed. There's the quick ball. Away they go to no one. Oh my word. Bob doesn't find his man. That is sinful. Jason Roo picks it up, but they are way behind the gain line. Soul destroying for Witteburg. In there's Van Billion. Here's Bob again. Flings it out to Skunrod. This is Liamza James. He's looked for work throughout the afternoon. Peter Jordan, his number 8, is quickly over to make the ball available. Stefan Jordan. with the Eli Kutsia right behind him. But Schoonrod, gee, they're up flat. Hunters Buerta, the big tight head, carries it on, rolling towards the line. Driven on by his teammates. Can they present it now?
Leave it now, leave it.
It comes for Witteburg. Bub, Schoonrod, Rue, Bianca, forward. Soul destroying for Witteburg. Their incursions to the 22 of Bethlehem Voortrekker have seldom yielded anything.
Directions of the hand, even though it does look like it's going back, it was definitely forward. Referee and CB perfectly placed, but it's been the story of the afternoon for Witteburg. Every time they go through a good phase of play, maintain possession, either a little unforced error or a forward pass comes into play to break down momentum.
Desperate times for Witteburg. They are trying for all they're worth. And it'll be a 22-meter dropout.
It was a good scrum from Bethlehem Voortrekker, but good pressure from opposition captain Dean Bubb.
The skipper putting his heart and soul on the line there. Deep, he will be beneath it now, will Bubb. And he takes. Up it goes to Daryl Wilson, trying to inject some urgency into this Witteburg side that win a penalty. They tap and go, and he nearly lost it. Here they come again. Wilson up to Jordan, playing with a lot more pace and energy. Hundis Buerta, he carried well moments ago. This time he's tasting the Bethlehem turf. Schoonrod, Bianca, Van Billion. The bounce is good for Mofokeng. He can't get away from this resolute defense. Bauer again has been so good on the tackle for Bethlehem Voortrekker. Stefan Jordan, Van Billion is the support player. Again, advantage for Witteburg. Away they come to Schoonrod. Long pass out of Buerta, shows very good hands for a prop-board. Liamza James can't get away from a despairing tackle. Kutsia picks it up and drives. They are coming alive by way of their desperation, and they will have another penalty as time ticks away here, approaching the last 10 minutes of this match, and Witteburg still trail by 15. They take the tap, and off they go. Jason Rue sees a wall of dark jerseys in front of him. They try to speed it up, but they didn't have the numbers. Another penalty. Is it going to be? Yes, it is. I wonder whether he'll go to his card. Bianca sets off, spins it. Buerta, the pass to no one, and it's intercepted. From forwards, trying to have sleight of hand in the back line is never advisable. Becker, Labuschagne, off he goes. The crowd scream, go wild. He's caught the try line, top of your screen.
Go two.
Becker, back to Boa, puts it on his left boot, and everyone breathes as he finds a safe touch.
It's been a good couple of minutes for the Witteburg side, but not coming away with points. So Bethlehem Voortrekker will take massive confidence from this, leading 18 points to 3. They have been very solid in defence this afternoon. Their first time tackles have been ruthless.
No, they've been quicker to the breakdown. Cornelia Mayren. On Schoonrod, up to Rue, crash ball, there's that defense again, and again, two tackles made by Peter Kleinhans, both of them high. I wonder whether they're going to play with 14 men now.
No more, no more.
There's the warning.
No more.
No more, says referee Busi Msebi. Otherwise, they'll be down to
just
14 men.
There's not two of you receiving.
It's been
the
all Witteburg for the last 5 minutes, but they haven't been able to get points.
Definitely a hard tackle from Peter Kleinhans, the loose head prop. And the warning has gone out. No more.
Camping inside the 22 now of Witteburg. Here's the line-out. There's the win from Jordan. Down to Dean Bubb. Away to Schoenraad. Liamza James. Telegraph pass to Kurbis Gunter. And he gets mowed down on the 22. And they've turned it over. Labiskashny. And space. Away comes Lombard. Still going Lombard. He's got support from Labiskashny. There's just a hand in there.
Backwards.
Now they come from Andre Klaasa. Labiskashny, can he get away for his second? This has been the feature of Voortrekker. Defend, 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 and then make the ball, points count the on the counter. Becker, little toe ahead by Fonsail. And into touch it goes. But all that territory has been lost by Witteburg. And that's got to be morale boosting for Voortrekker and soul destroying for the home side.
Soul destroying it is. Supremacy for 5 minutes, almost there to go and score, and you find yourself defending a line out deep in the red zone where you have struggled all afternoon. With Voortrekker have been Voortrekker been prominent with their two lock forwards, even Klaassen and Berger Marais.
Throw over the top, taken by Fonsail. Oh, driven back uncompromisingly. It gets it away to Kleinhans. The lean flicker of the fly half burrows his way towards the line. Becker digging, they drive towards the post. This would be the clincher for Bethlehem Voortrekker if they can get in. Becker up to Malencia, lost forward. So Witteburg will breathe again, but they are certainly gasping.
What is an overthrow? But what defense! That is a smashing tackle right on the line from the little fly half, Tian Schoenraad, taking back Tian Fonsail, the hooker from Voortrekker. That is commitment and courage.
Just had a period of 5 or 6 minutes in the middle of this half where they went to sleep. Witteburg gave away the try.
Nine.
A lot of errors crept in.
Six.
Voortrekker are likely to win and certainly have been valued for that, but Witteburg, the scoreline doesn't do them justice. Bub, away to Schoenraad. He looks for safety. Victor well placed, just inside his own half, and off goes the fullback. Direct running, steps, goes, runs into Shepi Mofokeng.
Right, get out.
They just need to keep the ball now. Kleinhans, it's a good tackle on Zwanrik Eger. Their control has been good though, as Bethlehem Voortrekker, looking for runners. Oh my word, there's another hit. The tackle on Peter Kleinhans by Henny Kutsia. No love lost between these two sets of forwards. The penalty goes Voortrekker's way. But there's going to be some schoolboys feeling very, very sore tomorrow morning.
Number four.
Well, it was a thumping tackle from Henny Kutsia. Timing was perfect, the correct shoulder, correct leg, straight in, perfect body position in playing the ball from an offsides position. So therefore, once again, Bethlehem with an opportunity to feed at the line-out.
Tough times for Witteburg. They must know that time is not on their side. The scoreboard, the gap is too much now. And another year will go by, and Bethlehem Voortrekker will prevail. Fonsail, Marais has been so solid. Away they come. The loose trio of Bethlehem Voortrekker have been really good. The young Michael Janssen van Rensburg, Saki Molense, that one of the try scorers, and Jean-Rick Eger. And they have the scrum. And they can start to celebrate, Bethlehem Voortrekker. You go back to 2006, the last time Witteburg prevailed in this FNB Classic clash. It must be soul destroying. You want it so much every year, but it just won't come.
Fight form, guys.
Well, it is soul destroying. They started off so well in the first half. Since that late try in the first half by Labiskashny, the tides had changed. In the second half, Bethlehem came out firing.
Yeah,
Now you must move up closer, yes.
They're hurting physically and mentally now.
Crouch. Bind.
That has been a feature of this game, the committed defense of both these sides. Another penalty quickly taken by Becker. He's away. Had they retreated the requisite distance? Probably not, but will it matter? They're over the line now. Can they get it down? They pushed a little back. Still contesting for it. Screaming are the crowd. And they will come because they hadn't retreated for the re-awarding of the penalty advance.
Oh, not back 10. Slow it down. Put the ball into the corner. Set up your line-out. It's been prominent all afternoon in the form of Berger Marais and the good line-out feeds from Tian Fonsella.
Wow. Pick the scrum.
Mark of the line.
That's making a late statement in this game, isn't it?
Well, they've also been impressive at scrum time, Brett. Needed to say, that's where big games are won. They won up front with quality position up front at scrum time and line-outs, and that's where they've made the difference this afternoon.
Can they rub salt into the already gaping Witteburg wound and get in for
Crouch?
A third try?
Fine.
Lavaskachny right at the end of the first half. Molense midway in this second half. And that really
open the gap.
Well, has proved to be the clincher. But a minute and change remain. And one more chance for Bethlehem Voortrekker to assert their authority. To show their dominance in this game.
Fine.
That really has been hard fought. Becker, who has been successful with the boot. They are being driven back this time, unusually so. There's the pick up and go from Jente van Rensburg. The drive from them over the line. Now, can they get it down? Well, the blast from referee and CB wasn't a convincing one. Held up again, so they will try once more. Smiles are already there as they know they are seconds away from the match that means the most during the year, the derby, the FNB Classic clash. They will prevail over Witteburg once again.
The ball held up, well defended from the Witteburg side. Once again, they'll have a strike 5 meters out.
Will they finish it off in style? Here they go. That's good attention from Dean Bubb. They pour into Witteburg. Can they go the length of the field for a score that may give them some degree of pride? They certainly have to run it when they can release this ball. Or they lose it. Oh, it's a scrum cap that comes forward. But they have lost the ball nonetheless. Claimed illegally. Is there a little bit of something on the deck there?
Six.
Oh, dear. Who's being spoken
can't
to?
That, eh? Can't pull the guy by the scrum text and choke him. He's come six.
He wrenched six off the scrum cap. Not happy as referee Msibi.
Saki Molense has had a solid afternoon. Been very good in defense. Carried the ball well.
Now he's been sent to the bin. So he will take no further part in the seconds that remain. Well, if he kicks it into touch, surely that's it. Referee's obviously decided there's time for the lineup. If there was going to be one, he doesn't find touch. So Lombard sets off. Goes to ground. He's been impressive, the left winger, with his carrying and his speed. The kick into touch is all they need, because there goes the final whistle. And look at that reaction from Bethlehem Voortrekker. That is how much this victory means. The winning of the Bethlehem Derby, the FNB Classic Clash. Delight for a side that deserves the victory. My word, it means so much to the players and the school. And by contrast, there are prone bodies in white shirts showing the despair of defeat.
Well, total jubilation. Look at these school kids. They're absolutely thrilled to win this game. 18 points to 3 against their arch rivals, Hoërskool Witteburg.
So the final score here, 2-0, Voortrekker beating Witteburg. Having led 10-3 at the break, Bethlehem Voortrekker have prevailed 18 points to 3.